Surprise Comics.
I currently have 4 opportunities to win some awesome CGC graded comic books. Number 1, sign up for the newsletter at brycecomics.com and every month you stay subscribed, you're entered to win a new slab. Number 2, subscribe to this channel, comment on this video, and like this video, and you're entered to win, bink, my brand new Tyler Kirkham exclusive for Noctera Blacktop Bill special. Number 3, head over to my Instagram page for another opportunity to win a separate copy of this. And number 4, head on over to Tyler Kirkham's Instagram page for another opportunity to win yet another CGC 9.8 Signature Series version of Noctera Blacktop Bill Special, which releases today. I am incredibly excited for this. Still pinching myself that I get to work with artists like Tyler Kirkham to create exclusive, unique art for my comic book shop. I am humbled and honored and so grateful to all of you for all the support. And Noctera Blacktop Bill Special is a one-shot that details the origin of Blacktop Bill. Blacktop Bill is the big bad for the Noctera series. The Noctera series has been optioned. There's a writer attached. It's coming to Netflix. This thing is coming. So there's a little bit of spec potential behind this book, in addition to just an awesome piece of artwork from Tyler Kirkham. A truly unique collectible. And the best thing is you get to support this channel. If you get anything out of this channel at all, this is the best way to currently support it, is to pick up this awesome exclusive. It's limited to 400 total copies. There's a limited number of CGC 9.8 Signature Series. There's also going to be regular CGC options and raw near mint copies. The raw near mint copies are going to be Mylar'd with full backboards and Gemini mailers, all that. And everything comes with a really awesome, unique, signed certificate of authenticity. So a little bit about the Noctera series. The only way to survive is to stay in the light or hitch a ride with Valentina, the ferryman who escorts people and goods along unlit roads with her luminescent 18-wheeler. This series is a really good read, visually stunning artwork. And the one-shot for Blacktop Bill is a standalone issue which details the origin of Blacktop Bill. But it's also a standalone issue, so you can start with the one-shot or you can start with Noctera issues 1 through 5. They also have a trade paperback that just came out, and I do recommend the series. I'm really enjoying it. Thank you. I'm truly grateful for all of you, my friends, my subscribers. Thank you so much for the support. And today's video is 6 keys under $25, a price point that I think most of us can get behind. And most of these were pulled from the list over at Key Collector Comics. Be sure to check out the category for this over on Key Collector. They have a bunch of other comics listed for under $25. But these are my top picks from that category that I think have the most potential. And use code BRYCECOMICS for a free 2-week trial of the app. So let's get right into it with Uncanny X-Men 282, the second print. This is the first cover and cameo appearance of Bishop, who appears in the final panel, and it's the first cameo team appearance of the XSE, the Xavier Security Enforcers, in Bishop, Malcolm, and Randall. So this is an X-Men key first appearance of a character that is likely to make his way into the MCU at some point for under $25 for a near mint copy, and we really could just leave it at that, but it gets a little bit better. The first print sells for a little more than the gold second print, but check out the census numbers for this issue. The first print has over 1,500 CGC 9.8s and over 5,000 total copies on the census, while the second print has 35 CGC 9.8s and 163 total copies on the census. It's absolutely bananas that the second print doesn't demand more of a premium than the first print. I think it even looks cooler with the gold background, but it's also like 35 times more rare. And if you look at available copies on eBay, there are about 25 listings for the second print compared to hundreds and hundreds of listings for the first print. And I've made a note to do a video about why sometimes subsequent prints are worth more and sometimes they aren't, because I'm going to have to do some research on this as to why it's the case for this book. So make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on that video. Next Next up, we have Uncanny X-Men number 184, and this is the first appearance of Forge, Daniel Lone Eagle, a mutant with the ability to comprehend and build nearly anything technological. It's also the first appearance of Naze, a Cheyenne mystic and mentor to Forge, who's later revealed to be the adversary. And here we get two first appearances in an X-Men title for under $25. X-Men is so super hot right now. This may be the last chance to grab some of these sleeper keys, and for under $25, why not? Especially since this is like a $300 book in a CGC 9.8. It's a great book to buy raw, get graded, and flip, or it's also a great long-term hold. If one of these characters ends up having a future on the big or small screen, it could be a nice payday, not to mention some pretty epic artwork by John Romita Jr. to enjoy in the meantime. Next on the list, we have Taskmaster number 3, and this is the first appearance of Taiguki, a Korean superhero, and it's the first partial appearance of Tiger Division. And the reason I like this spec is, one, it's under $25. Sometimes it's more near the $10 range for a near raw copy. And two, Marvel is always doubling down on diversity characters. It seems like a great low-entry, high-potential payoff spec. And three, this issue wasn't overprinted. It's Taskmaster 3. People weren't exactly speculating on Taskmaster 3 and buying hundreds of copies of this pre-order, so most of us were surprised that this was an important key first appearance when it came out. There's only 163 copies on the CGC census so far, and 30 total copies on the census for the 1 in 25, which is a lot more pricey, but would definitely be the money book if anything came of this spec. So if you're able to pay a little more than 25, I would definitely check out that 1 in 25 variant. Next on the list, we have Spider-Gwen number 1, cover A, and this is the premiere issue of the first Spider-Gwen titled series. And I don't know about you guys, but after seeing the trailer for Across the Spider-Verse, I am pumped for Spider-Gwen. And that's just the animated movie. Imagine if and when she makes it to the MCU in a live action with like some big name actress attached to it. People are going to go absolutely nuts. Her first appearance is going to be so far out of reach for most people that they will be more than happy to land on this copy with epic artwork by Robbie Rodriguez for a Spider-Gwen number 1. And my only regret at this point is selling a bunch of my copies of cover A. Next on the list, we have Miles Morales, Spider-Man number 13. This is the first appearance of Billy Morales, the sister of Miles Morales. And here's my thought process on this. We are likely in the very beginning stages of the Miles Morales empire that I think is inevitably right around the corner. I think Miles Morales is going to have his own franchise. I think it's going to be separate from the Spider-Man franchise. I think it's going to go on for years with movie after movie and spinoff after spinoff. And so why not pick up some of these lesser keys while they are still under $25? They are going to have to dig deep in the source material to keep these shows and movies going. And so it's likely that his sister Billy will show up and become something more at some point. All of the variants for this issue can be had for under $25, except the Raza variant, which will be the money book and is worth considering if you can spend more than $25. Next on the list, we have Alpha Flight number 51, and this is the first full issue with interior artwork by Jim Lee at Marvel Comics, and this is a book that is more around the $10 range for a raw near mint copy, with CGC 9.8s around the $175 mark. So it's a great book to pick up raw, get graded, and flip, and it's also a great long-term hold. And here's my thought process on this. Jim Lee is never going to be less popular. He's only going to become more and more popular as time goes on. His fan base will forever expand, meaning there's tons of upside for this book. There's only 76 9.8s on the census and 254 total CGC graded copies. So I think this is a speculation route that many people haven't fully considered yet, and that is going for the first artwork for major artists. If you're looking for the first ever published artwork by Jim Lee, you're going to have to fork out a bit more cash to get the Solson Christmas Special number 1 featuring Samurai Santa, which clearly needs to be retconned. We absolutely need a Samurai Santa in the MCU. Don't forget to head over to briascomics.com and secure your copy of Noctera Blacktop Bill Special. There's those four opportunities to win a free CGC 9.8 Signature Series copy signed by Tyler Kirkham. Thank you so much for the support. I truly appreciate all of you, and we'll catch you in the next video. Bye.
Comics.